Well, it's here, Ryzen 7000 launch day. The reviews have all happened and now it's time to, I don't know, do you pull the trigger? Are they gonna sell out? What do I do, Robey? Do I need to upgrade? Do I need to buy now? Well, hold your horses. Let's see, does it make sense to upgrade to Ryzen 7000 right now? Well, let's dig into that problem, shall we? So welcome to the first of the Robeytech coverage on the Ryzen 7000, and big shout out to Newegg for helping us get coverage of AMD's new 7000 series of CPUs. We have a different embargo, so we're today, everybody else was yesterday, but you know what, we're chill with that because we got to take all of the information and make this great little guide for you. So all the reviews are out, and now you have a ton of information, but the question is, does it make sense right now to pull the trigger? I mean, don't get me wrong. We came to all the same conclusions as so many of our favorite tech YouTubers did, Jay, Linus, ours are more aligned with Linus's. But we did all of our tests and had all of our numbers, and we're super impressed with the multi-core information. But unlike many of us tech reviewers, you don't have access to like a large pool of hardware, and I also don't think most of you are independently wealthy. I don't know, maybe you are. So what you wanna know is, do I spend my money right now on a new rig or upgrade my current rig with these brand new shiny CPUs from AMD, or is there something else that I don't know? Should I wait? Should I hold on? What should I do, Robey? Okay, so here's the deal. By the way, I am gonna be focusing on gamers and streamers, given that's the majority of my audience. I'm guessing most of you look at what your workload is and you can very clearly understand if this is something you wanna do. But a lot of the same things are gonna apply here, so feel free to listen. And then if you have questions, put them down in the comments below. And while you're down there, make sure you like and subscribe. So let's start with the first scenario, shall we? You're coming off of the Ryzen 5000 series or an older Ryzen AM4 CPU series. You're in the Ryzen family, and more than likely, the jump to Ryzen 7000 series is more appealing because brand loyalty is a thing, as is familiarity. You're used to the Radeon, the Radeon software and Adrenaline software and all that sort of stuff, and you just want it to be the same. So the answer here is actually a little bit more complicated than I expected, because as much of a generational leap that we're getting in so many ways with Ryzen 7000, what we haven't necessarily seen is like a massive, massive performance in when it comes to gaming. Yes, what we can say is that Ryzen 7000 series are in fact the best gaming CPUs on the market based on all of the current reviews that are out there and the data that we have. But there are some people who played the right games and got Intel to look a bit better, and then there's some people who played a lot of AMD games and made that look better. But what I can say is that based on our own internal testing and the fact that things are gonna get better with driver updates, that I think that we have the current king in the short term right now. We don't know what's happening in the future. But one thing that kind of threw a pothole in the whole thing with AMD was the Ryzen 7 5800X3D. See, when you look at many of the benchmarks for CPU-bound titles, like things like CSGO and Rainbow Six Siege or Valorant, etc., across the family of Ryzen 7000 series CPUs, you actually see that the Ryzen 7 5800X3D is close, or in some cases ties, the Ryzen 7000 series. And here's the deal. These are the games where you are going to see the biggest uplift from a CPU and only at 1080p. And I think, you know, so many people, it's like when we talk about titles that are GPU bound or CPU bound, basically what it means is that the GPU can't give information fast enough to the CPU that the CPU can't handle it, and therefore we start to see these big uplifts. Now, to be clear, the uplift in these titles is big, but now instead of being able to play games at like in the high 600s for like CSGO, now you get to play at like 800 frames per second, which honestly is pointless, because right now anything north of 360 frames is more than good enough. And with both the 5800X3D and the 7000 series, even your 1% lows, meaning 99% of the time your frame rate will be higher than that number, are also well north of 360 frames per second, meaning that these games, when paired with the right GPU, can easily push the frames, the highest frame rate monitors. Now, when you start getting into non-CPU bound titles, AKA the one where work is more on the GPU than on the CPU, this is where things just kind of even out. And it becomes more like, what platform does it support, whether it's Intel or AMD, and things kind of flip-flop depending on the title. And this is why some people are like saying Intel's king, and other people are saying AMD's king. But in the end, there isn't really a clear winner, because because it's really more about the GPU than it is about the CPU. So to be clear, if you move down the GPU stack from a 3090 Ti to a 3070 or a 6700 XT, then these graphs start to flatten even more because the GPU can't hand the data to the CPU fast enough, and therefore your frame rate numbers go down. Okay, Robey, well, that was a bunch of really good data, and I've seen all of that from all the other reviews I've already seen on YouTube, of which there were a bajillion. So what does that mean? So here's where it gets interesting for you folks who might be on the existing AM4 platform and you want to jump up to Ryzen 7000 series. Then just here's the deal, it's not a cheap endeavor. See, now that AMD is on the new AM5 platform, it has now had all the goodies that Intel got with the jump up to Alder Lake or 12th gen. Things like DDR5 and PCIe Gen 5, and that's all good, but unlike Alder Lake or 12th gen, AM5 won't be supporting DDR4, and that means you not only need a new CPU, which costs $299 if you were just gonna get the 7600X, or $399 for the 7700X, or $549 for the 7900X, and $699 if you wanna go all in for the 7950X, but it's also a new motherboard, and let's just say you wanna get something like on the cheap, like the MSI Pro X670-P Wi-Fi, which is a good board, but it's more easy on the budget options, and that's still gonna cost you $289.99. And finally, you need RAM, because it's only DDR5. So let's choose this G-Skill Flare X5 DDR5 from Newegg, and that would be another $159.99. So minimum, you're gonna spend approximately $749, and that's only if you have a great cooler, because one thing worth mentioning, and we have a video coming out on this very soon, is that the CPUs intentionally run hot to ensure maximum performance, so skimping on cooling will affect your performance later on. And it's not a bad thing, it's all good, but it's now different. So here's the choice to kind of help you boil it down. If you're hurting and you need to upgrade, and I'm gonna let you decide if you need to upgrade, then you could spend $749 at a minimum, and that's a 7600X, an entry-level X670 board, and some 5600 megahertz RAM, if you wanted to just go entry-level and then be on AM5 platform, which has all the latest and greatest, and hope that AMD does stick to its promise of supporting AM5 beyond 2025, or you could just spend $449 on a 5800X 3D and get pretty dang close, if not on par performance in some games, than any of the 7000 series at 1080p. And then almost have the same performance at higher resolutions, given the CPU becomes less important. Here's a funny thing, and I don't know, this is gonna be interesting. I know we've been poking at NVIDIA, or more than poking, we've been stabbing at NVIDIA for pricing here, but I'm not sure why the 5800X 3D isn't cheaper given the price of the 5900X and the 5800X. I'm sorry, it just seems like AMD knows that it's competing against itself, and if that was cheaper, well, then going to 7000 series for gaming gets even tougher. So that's if you're in the AM4 camp, okay? And you wanted to upgrade. The answer is up to you. Like, do you choose go old gen and maybe perhaps like just ink it out and see what's coming up, or do you just go ahead and upgrade and do it at a minimum cost? But there is a higher cost if you were to move up to AM5. What about if you're on Team Blue? What if you have 12th gen or a much older Intel and you've heard all this great stuff about AMD and you have an aging Intel CPU and maybe making the jump over to AM5 now makes sense? Well, what I'm gonna say is the same thing I'm gonna say to the AM4 folks who are looking over the fence at the greener pastures of AM5. They also, which also applies to you. You know what, maybe the deal is that you're happy with Intel, and so the jump isn't so potentially straightforward. See, today, when this video is releasing, we're gonna be getting all the information on Intel's new Raptor Lake, along with its release date and its claims against what reviewers and AMD have been saying and posting about AMD 7000 series. You gotta bet that this whole thing and the timing is absolutely strategic on the day that 7000 series goes for sale. Now, a lot of it is dependent on what comes out of that announcement from Intel, but let's say it hits all its rumored numbers and it gets 5.8 gigahertz and has a slight uplift over 7000 series, or even ends up being the same. Then unlike AM5, you could go pick up an older Z690 board or B660 board and cheaper DDR4 and upgrade to Intel's 13th gen CPU. It will be cheaper, and to go Team Blue, and depending on how that number is, it may make even more sense. However, Unlike AMD, we don't have a promise of how long LGA 1700 is gonna last. That's Intel's version of AM5, their socket. And will it be supported? And unlike the hopes of AM5, you may not get that long-term growth opportunity like you would with AMD. Now, I'm still gonna use the word may, because as Linus so correctly pointed out, they being AMD, have gone back on their word in previous. I don't think it's lying. I think it's just, you know, sometimes you just have to move forward like you did. And like what they did with the Threadripper socket. So the short answer after all that is wait. As exciting as the new CPU launch is, and we have a plethora of new hardware that's coming out very soon that could ultimately impact your decision one way or the other. Intel's 13th generation should be a part of your equation first before making any leap, and knowing the whole picture will definitely allow you to make a more informed purchasing decision on which route you may want to take. I'm actually going to take it a bit further. See, I think everybody should wait. I really honestly do, because, and probably a little bit longer than you're probably expecting me to say. See, I think everyone needs to wait until after the AMD announcement on RDNA 3 on November 3rd. Wait, Robey, what does that have anything to do with CPU and which CPU I should put into my system? Calm down there, Tiger, and let me explain. See, in a video I recently released about the AMD Radeon 6950 XT, you can see that there's a technology called Smart Access Memory that AMD talked about with RDNA 2 that actually started with the fact that if you paired an AMD CPU and an AMD GPU, you saw an even bigger uplift in gaming. Now, here's the deal. I know that Smart Access Memory and Rebar is now available across the board with NVIDIA and Intel. But the point is that it started there. And here's the deal. AMD is one of the few companies that can take over the entire pipeline of your PC and potentially create uplift. Now, Intel's playing catch up with the eventual release of the Intel Arc, but AMD is on multiple iterations of this now, and you're seeing its benefits pop up with like the laptop space with what's called AMD Advantage. Now, if you want to see more on that, then you should check out our video on the Evo 16S right here, because it talks a little bit about what some of those things that AMD could do. Now, I want to see if Team Red may, if anything, have up their sleeve here, because we may get some surprises that may want you to go 7000 series, and that might be a smarter call because you can pair that with even higher uplift with a Radeon 7000 series GPU. Also, with the announcement being so far after both 7000 series and 13th gen, AMD could even take that opportunity to hint at a potential 3D cache version of 7000 series, which would make gaming uplift that much bigger and give you, well, unfortunately, an even longer wait. The thing is that honestly, you know, when you look at the numbers that we were showing earlier, the uplift between, you know, current gen, 12th gen, and 7000 series from a gaming standpoint, there's not a whole lot Intel really needs to do to get up there again. And it feels like with what you've seen the 5800X3D could do, I don't know, a mid-generation CPU thing kind of feels like it's almost a given from AMD at this point in time. This takes me to my last group of people, the ones who want to jump into the world of PC gaming and PC Master Race and come hang out with the rest of us. You know, they may be looking to build their first PC right now. They're done with console. They see a lot of things coming on here, and they want to come and be part of the party. Well, guys, it's a super exciting time to get into PC gaming. And like the Intel folks or the AM4 folks or so many who could potentially be looking to jump over to Team Red, I'm gonna suggest you wait as well. Look, right now, there is a lot of unknowns when it comes to what the best CPU is going to be for the next rig. But the best thing about it is that a lot of those questions are gonna be answered in probably the next 6 weeks. I would say I'm not gonna worry too much about CPU selling out and not being available going into the holiday season. A lot of the same concerns that really hammered on the PC sector during the pandemic aren't at play here anymore. And one thing that the pandemic did do was bring a lot of folks up to date on PC hardware. So I really do believe that AMD will keep up with demand, even though you might see things sell out pretty quick right after this, but I have a feeling stock's not gonna be much of an issue. So wrapping it up, hopefully I took all of the information that came out of yesterday's crazy amount of information, injected our own data inside of it, and helped boil it down into something a lot simpler to process. On the gaming side, when it comes to CPUs and where the CPUs lie, as of 7000 series release, it's not as straightforward to make a call when what the right decision is to invest more money into if that's your current gaming rig or if you wanted to buy a new rig, but I wanted to highlight all the factors that you should keep in mind when you are trying to make that decision. As in any one of these videos, I will always say it needs to start with being honest with yourself about what it is that you actually need and being patient on your purchase, if you can, to try and get all of the information and feel confident you made the right choice for when it comes to purchasing hardware. The last thing I want is if you could have found out, waited 2 weeks and ended up having buyer's remorse because there was another decision that there was something I warned you about that you're like, dang it, Robey, I wish you would have listened to you. But here, it's not about what I think. I would love to hear what you think. Did this video actually help you? I'd love to know your thoughts. And you know what, maybe you could win a little cash in the process. First and foremost, you need to leave a quality comment down below along with liking and subscribing to the channel. Now, when I say quality comment, it doesn't need to be positive. It just needs to be something you liked or didn't like about the video, what surprised you, etc., about the uplift or anything like that. Just not, hey, I deserve to win. Can I have a free 7950X or anything else like weird or lame like that. You also need to ensure we have a way to reach you via your YouTube profile, like your email. So put your email in your YouTube profile, and no, we're not using it for anything else nefarious, but we are giving away $25 to one lucky comment below. That is worldwide, as long as you can accept PayPal or Venmo. But if you don't have your email in your YouTube profile, we can't tell you you've won, and therefore, you can't win. Okay, so the question is, what do you think of my upgrade breakdown? Was there something that I missed? Do you agree with my points? And are you gonna be buying 7000 series now, or are you potentially gonna be waiting? I would love to know all of that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so you get a notification each and every time we post a new video right here on Robeytech. Do you know we have a live stream channel for special builds and events? Well, you know what? We build custom PCs. We're gonna be building 7000 series PCs starting tonight when you're seeing this. And we test pre-builds as well. So check out Robeytech Live down in the description below so you can like and subscribe to know when we go live and you don't miss one of those awesome build videos like that. If you have questions about 7000 series or other tech-related questions, then check out our amazing Discord server over at discord.gg/Robeytech filled with other tech and PC enthusiasts that love to share their thoughts and ideas on these very subjects. Are you looking for cheap tech? Maybe you want to know when AMD 7000 is coming out, or Radeon, or NVIDIA. Then check out at Robeytech.com or at Robeytech Deals on Twitter, where we have our guy Tom scouring the internet for the best deals on all things tech and PC components, GPUs, CPUs, you name it. Finally, you can follow me and my entire team on all the other socials at Robeytech absolutely everywhere. We really hope you enjoyed this video, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.